What is up, guys? Welcome to the video. We are less than 10 days out from the marathon. It is Thursday. We just got done rolling a little bit with some jujitsu. I forgot to get clips of that, but we're in here about to get some clips for another video we're working on. And yeah. So what do you think? What's your prediction for the marathon?
I mean, I think you got 3:30 in the bag. I think if the hills aren't crazy, I think you got 3:30 easy. But I mean, if there's some crazy hills, and depending on the weather, I mean, who knows what can happen. But I'm pretty confident you'll get 3:30. I'm pretty confident.
Dude, that 3:30 would be sick.
Yeah.
3:30 would be sick.
I mean, you've been moving good, so I'm not too worried.
Yeah, we'll see. What is up, guys? So it is the next day. We have a track workout today. We have a 2 mile warm up, 3 to 4 1 mile repeats, followed by a 2 mile cool down. I've already done the 2 mile warm up. I'll put that on the screen and we'll get into the repeats right now. Okay, so that first repeat was at 5:40. That was about an RPE of 8 or 9. I'm gonna dial it back a little bit, but let's get into repeat number 2. Okay, so we just finished repeat number 2 at 5:56. Still a little quicker than I wanna be. I wanna dial it back just a little bit, but we got one more repeat. Get into it. Okay, so we just finished our third and final repeat. It's 6 minutes flat. Now we're gonna get into a 2 mile cool down. Okay, so we just made it home from that workout. I'll put the 2 cool down miles on the screen for you guys, but I figured we could talk about the taper now. And we can talk about why we tapered. We tapered to try to reduce the fatigue in our body. Like 3 weeks out from the marathon was pretty much our peak mileage weeks. That was whenever we were running 20 miles on the weekend as our distance runs and stuff. We were running close to 50 miles those weeks, and I'll put the mileage on the screen for you guys. I'm still following this program that I've been following this entire marathon prep, and it has the taper weeks for me. So I'll put the mileages on the screen for you guys for the last 2 weeks of this prep, but I'll get into the more nuance of exactly what we're doing. 2 weeks out from the marathon, which would be right now, we're like about a week and a half out from the marathon. We're still keeping the same intensity, as in we're still doing a track workout as we did earlier in this video. Our mileage is getting lower to try to freshen up our legs again so we can be at our best on race day. During these last 2 weeks, we're not really even gonna be building any fitness. And I mentioned in another video how I kind of procrastinate sometimes. And with this, like, there is no procrastinating. If I miss days, weeks of training, and I'm like, oh, we're 2 weeks out from the marathon, I better make up for those 2 weeks, it's not gonna happen. It takes time and consistency to build an aerobic base. It's not like studying for a final, I'm cramming all this stuff into my brain 12 hours before the test. It's like, no, like, you can't cram fitness in. Like, we're pretty much, we're set. The hay is in the barn, as they say. All the fitness we have done, the 6 months of training, it's done. Like, right now we are trying to maintain our fitness and lower our volume so our body can be, again, fresh for race day, but we are not gonna be building any fitness these last 2 weeks. And next week will be a little different. That mileage I showed you on the screen, we're pretty much gonna cut that in half, and we won't have an intense track workout like we did today next week whenever we're days away from the marathon, so we can freshen up our legs and be ready to run sub 4 hours on race day. But I mean, it's pretty simple, but I just thought I would update you guys on the taper and why we're tapering and my plan on how I'm going to taper. I'm sure it's not gonna be perfect. I'm sure I will learn from it, from any mistakes I do make, so the next marathon can be closer to perfect. But yeah, again, that's our plan. I figured I would share that with you guys. Now we're going to head to the gym. Okay, so we just made it to the gym. We're about to jump into a session. Forgot to mention, this last week I've had major GI issues, which is really annoying because I really don't know what to do about it. This isn't the first time this has happened though. It's like 2 months ago, I had that really the only bad week of this marathon prep that I've had. Like I've missed a training session or mileage I was supposed to get. It was a couple months ago whenever I had the same issues, but that lasted a week. So hopefully after this week is over, it'll go away, because if it happens on race day, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be super frustrated because I just don't know what to do about it. I can't go more than 2 miles without having to go to the bathroom. And that sucks on distance runs because I like to go out and run a big ass circle, and there's not always a bathroom near me. And that's the worst feeling in the world, is being 7 miles away from a fucking bathroom. But I just thought I would share that information with you. If you have any tips on how to fix this, I've been doing a little research into lower my fiber intake, especially a couple hours before the run. And I've also learned that like 9 out of 10 runners deal with this. I'm not the only one, so just have to power through it, I guess. Again, hopefully after this week it's all said and done and we can just move forward for the week of the race. But yeah, we're gonna jump into this workout session. No, I don't run away as a savage. Yeah, I do it for no reason, that's just savage. I deserve something different than average. If you don't die for the weekend, give me your blessings. I ain't gon' judge it, we don't know better. I ain't the only nigga, so there ain't no pressure. Just come and get it, I know you ready. It's automatic. That arm workout, super easy basic arm workout. I always get in my head thinking I'm doing too simple of exercises and showing them to you guys, and you don't have to do these crazy extravagant exercises to get the results you want. All you have to do is make sure you're doing exercises properly, you're doing them consistently, and really focusing on progressive overload. You're pushing yourselves in your workouts and progressing with the weight, reps, or sets. But yeah, that's what we just wrapped up. Basically just supersetting a bicep exercise with a tricep exercise. Supersetting means we're not taking a rest in between those two exercises. We'll bounce back from one exercise to the next, and then we will take a rest in between sets. But yeah, I've already put the workout on the screen for you guys. That's pretty much gonna wrap up the video. We're a little over a week out from the marathon. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next one.